exercises or the solution for the textual exercises on the chapter of linear equations. Pertaining to your algebra syllabus, I am going to upload this video now. Now let us consider exercise 3.2, under which I will be taking up the first problem now. And now the first problem is like this. If you subtract 1 by 2 from a number and multiply the result by 1 by 2, you get 1 by 8. What is the number? Now, when you examine the solution part of it, as I have been telling you in the online classes also, you have to bear one thing in mind. When such problems have to be solved here, first we have to convert the statement given to us in the form of a mathematical equation, which will allow us to solve the equation further and the solution becomes very easy. So, coming to the solution part of it, first I don't know what exactly is the value of that number, so I am going to take that number as x. Now, the next step is half subtracted from the given number is equal to x minus half, which I have taken it as my second step. Now in the third step, I am going to apply furthermore the given condition wherein the result is multiplied by half. So I am going to multiply x minus half by half. Now the next step is this value, that is half multiplied by x minus half, this will be equal to 1 by 8, which is already given to us. So I have equated it. Now half into x minus half is equal to 1 by 8. So I am going to remove the brackets and simplify now. Half into x will give me half x minus half into half is 1 by 4, which is equal to 1 by 8. Now, half x is taken in the left hand side. I am going to transpose 1 by 4 from LHS to RHS, that is minus 1 by 4. So when I do that, minus 1 by 4 becomes plus 1 by 4 when it is transposed to the right hand side. Thus, the equation becomes half x is equal to 1 by 8 plus 1 by 4. Now, half x or x by 2, they both are one and the same. That is equal to, now I am going to take the LCM between 8 and 4 here. 8 is the LCM. 8 ones are is 8 into whatever is there in the numerator, plus 4 twos are is 8 into whatever is there in the numerator, whole thing divided by 8. This is going to give me 3 by 8. So, the value of x by 2 is equal to 3 by 8. Now, on cross multiplication, I get it as 8x is equal to 6, or x is equal to 6 by 8, or in its simplest form, x is equal to 3 by 4. So this is a number, or this is a solution that we actually wanted. Now, coming to the verification part of it, how to verify whether your answer is correct or not? So for this, I have to consider this equation half x minus 1 by 4 is equal to 8. So wherever x is there, I am going to put or substitute 3 by 4 in that place to verify. So it is half into 3 by 4 minus 1 by 4. Okay. So this is going to give me 3 by 8 minus 1 by 4. On simplification, by taking the LCM and subtracting, I get 1 by 8, which is the required answer, and that is the RHS. So now you can see that LHS is equal to RHS, and thus the result that we have obtained is correct. Now, moving on to the second problem here. The second problem is like this. The perimeter of a rectangular swimming pool is 154 meters. Its length is 2 meter more than twice its breadth. What is the length and breadth of the pool? This is the question. Now, coming to the solution part of it. If you observe the problem carefully here, so the length is 2 meter more than twice its breadth. So, the length is more than the breadth, or twice the breadth is given to you. So first we have to consider this breadth as x meter here. So let the breadth be x meter. So what will the length become now? The length will become 2x plus 2 meter. Why 2x plus 2 meter? Because in the problem it is given to us that the length is 2 meter more than twice its breadth. Breadth is x, twice the breadth is 2 into x, and 2 meter more than twice the breadth is 2x plus 2 meter. Okay? And by the formula of the perimeter of the rectangle, we know that the perimeter is given by the formula 2 into length plus breadth here. And in the given problem, the perimeter is given to us as 154 meter. So this is going to give me 154 is equal to 2 into, wherever L is there, I am going to take 2x plus 2 plus wherever B or breadth is there, I am going to take x there. So now the equation becomes 154 is equal to 2 into 2x plus 2 plus x. Now on removing the bracket and simplifying, you have 154 is equal to 4x plus 4, because 2 into 2x plus 2 into 2 will give me 4x plus 4. Okay? Plus 2 into x is 2x. That is how I get this. So 154 is equal to 6x plus 4. I want only 6x on one side. So I transfer this plus 4 to the other side. Then it becomes minus 4. That is how I have 154 minus 4 is equal to 6x. So 150 is equal to 6x. I want only x here. So I send this 6 down to the denominator, and thus it becomes x is equal to 150 by 6, which is equal to 25 meter. Now this x is nothing but the breadth that we have considered. So now breadth is equal to x, which is equal to 25 meter. Now coming to the length. Length was considered as 2x plus 2. So wherever x is there, I am going to put 25 in that place here. Thus the length becomes 2 into 25 plus 2, which is equal to 50 plus 2, which is 52 meter. So length is 25 meter and width is, or breadth, length is 52 meter and breadth or width is 25 meter here. Now how to verify whether your answer is correct or not? So here we already have the equation as 6x is equal to 150. So 6 into x plus 4 is equal to 154. That is the equation that I have considered for verification here. So 6 into 25 plus 4 will give me 154. Also, when I take these values and substitute in L plus B, L plus B, which is a perimeter, twice of L plus B is equal to, twice of L is 52 here, I have taken that, plus breadth is 25 here, I have taken that within the brackets. So this is going to give me 2 into 52 plus 25 is equal to 77. So 2 into 77 is equal to 154, which is a, that means our answer is correct. So we have verified the answer also. So now coming to the third problem, the base of an isosceles triangle is 4 by 3 centimeter. So the perimeter of the triangle is 4, 2 by 15 centimeter. What is the length of the either of the remaining two sides? So this word either of the remaining two sides, you will get one clue here that we are talking about two sides which are actually equal. Either of the means we are finding out the equal sides here. One side is equal to other. This is a keyword. This either of the remaining two sides is the keyword that we are going to keep it in mind. So let us come to the solution part of it. So one of the either side or equal side, I have taken it as x here. So perimeter is given to us as 4, 2 by 15 centimeter, which when converted to improper fraction, it becomes 62 by 15 meter. Now the base is given to us as 4 by 3 meter. Okay, so now you know that perimeter is nothing but the sum of all the three sides of a triangle. So I am using that logic here. Perimeter is equal to 4 by 3, which is the first side, plus x, which is the second side, plus x again, which is the third side, because we know that in an isosceles triangle, the two sides are equal here. So it is an isosceles triangle, so two sides are equal here. You have to always remember that. So now, coming to the next step now, I am going to simplify this equation, and that is going to give me 62 by 15 is equal to 4 by 3 plus 2x. So now, I am going to keep only 2x on RHS. I will send this plus 4 by 3 to the LHS. It becomes minus 4 by 3. That's how I get the equation as 62 by 15 minus 4 by 3 is equal to 2x. Once again, I'm going to take the LCM between 15 and 3 here. 15 is the LCM. 15 ones are is 15 into 62, which is there in the numerator, minus 3 fives are is 15 into 4, which is there in the numerator, is equal to 2x. And here on the LHS, because the LCM is 15, I have divided the whole thing by 15 here. So I get the answer as 62 minus 20 whole thing by 15 minus or is equal to 2x there. It's not minus. It is equal to 2x. 42 by 15 is equal to 2x. So x will be equal to 42 by 15 twos are 30. So x is 7 by 5 on simplification, or in the mixed fraction, it is 1, 2 by 5 centimeter. So now, the length of the either of the remaining equal sides is equal to 7 by 5 centimeter, or 1, 2 by 5 centimeter, which is the required solution. Now coming to verification part of it. So we know that the perimeter is 4 by 3 plus x plus x, which is equal to 4 by 3 plus 7 by 5 plus 7 by 5. Wherever x is there, I have to put 7 by 5 here. This is going to give me 20 plus 21 plus 21 whole thing by 15, which is equal to 62 by 15. That means our answer is correct. So this is how we have verified this sum also. Now, coming to the next sum. Sum of two numbers is 95. If one exceeds the other by 50, find the numbers. So in this case, the first number is taken as x. The second number is exceeding the first number by 15. So what I have done here is, I have taken the second number as x plus 15. So the sum of x and x plus 15 is equal to 95. So I have taken the equation as x plus 15 is equal to 95. On simplification, it gives x plus x is 2x, so it is 2x plus 15 is equal to 95. So 2x, I want it on my LHS. I am going to transpose this plus 15 to RHS here. So it becomes minus 15. Thus, the equation becomes 2x is equal to 95 minus 15, or 2x is equal to 80. So x is equal to 80 by 2, which is equal to 40. So the first number is 40. We have already got the solution. The second number should be 40 plus 15, which is equal to 55. So how to verify this? Add the numbers. 40 plus 15, that is 80 plus 15 is equal to 95. Thus, the solution is obtained, and we have also verified the solution. Thank you, my dear children.